Regional security forces to help maintain order in hurricane-battered Dominica until year end. And in sport, the second test between West Indies and Zimbabwe ends in a draw. I'm Ricardo Roberts, and this is Caribbean in 10 for Thursday, November 2nd. I'll be back with the details after the break.
Grow your business or promote your event through the services offered by the Caribbean Media Corporation and Carib Vision. Our distribution provides a platform on cable, terrestrial television, and websites. We cover carnivals and events from across the region. We can bring your event live and alive to the world. For music makers, program producers, businesses, we can expand your reach to in excess of 2 million households daily. Our other services include news updates to enhance your media products, studio space for program and development. We can facilitate the launch of new products and services and training. Contact us and we will help you unleash your creative ability, develop products and services, and provide the medium to watch them grow. Contact Loretta Skeet at cmccaribbean.com or call her 1-246-467-1044 or 1-246-253-3889. Call and book your carnival or event today.
I really got my big break about 3 years ago when I had an opportunity to perform at the Miss World pageant in China. And there the whole world had an opportunity to see Caribbean colors and my costume, and I created this line dance called the Caribbean Slide.
Security officials from around the Caribbean will maintain a presence in Dominica until at least the end of the year as the island continues its recovery from the devastating Hurricane Maria. Police Chief Daniel Carbon made the disclosure yesterday as he heaped praises on the regional security system, the RSS, for helping to maintain order since the Category 5 hurricane hit the island in September. He said local police could not have brought the situation under control without the assistance of the regional forces, and he expressed those sentiments when he attended the meeting of RSS chiefs on Monday.
Made a case for the continued presence of the regional security system forces that are deployed here. And I must say that I got a tremendous commitment that the RSS will be with us right up to year end. And they have assured me that they will always stand with Dominica in our endeavors. And so I also say to them that the RSS forces from the various RSS islands have been giving a very good account of themselves. They've been executing their functions very professionally. Very little or no complaints.
Carbon said the RSS made other commitments to Dominica, but he told the media he could not disclose them until he had briefed Justice Minister Rayburn Blackmore. More than 1,000 Jamaican children were the victims of sexual offenses in 2016. The alarming figure was disclosed yesterday by UNICEF Jamaica as it shared findings of a report on violence against children in the island. According to data presented, there were 1,147 reported cases of sexual offenses against children. A breakdown of the data showed that 56 girls between ages of 1 and 10 were raped last year, and another 295 girls between 11 and 17 years were also violated in that way. There were 337 cases of rape of 18-year-old girls. There were also several cases of incest. In the case of boys, buggery was also a problem. There were 14 victims between ages 1 and 10, 12 victims between 11 and 17, and 8 who were 18 years old. UNICEF representatives to Jamaica, Mark Connolly, said the data was presented to bring about awareness and change and not to, quote, name and shame or show scary numbers on how bad things are, end quote. Minister of State in the Ministry of Education, Youth and Information, Floyd Green, said a national plan of action now in the draft stage will be rolled out soon to address the problem of violence against children. The Caribbean Court of Justice has given the Belize government until next week to pay up more than $62 million U.S. dollars to two companies under a settlement agreement dating back to 2015. The Trinidad-based court said the Dean Barrow administration would have to pay the money to Dunkeld International Investment Limited and the Belize Telemedia Employees Trust by November 10. A settlement agreement had been made between the parties and made an order of the CCJ in 2015. That agreement provided for calculating payment of compensation arising from the nationalization of Belize Telemedia Limited and associated companies. But there had been some dispute over the Belize and U.S. dollar figures. The CCJ says it's holding Belize to tough terms if the money is not paid up by November 10 deadline. Now, if the payment is not made in full by then, the government will have to fork out interest of 8.34% compounded quarterly on the remaining amount. Additionally, interest on the unpaid interest will be payable at the rate of 6% compounded monthly. Stay with us. Your Midday Sport is next.
Friend of mine that's, well, and actually my male friends, they think I'm crazy, but they love it. They think it's awesome. I don't know why more people don't do it, because it is, it's just a lot of fun. It's kind of intimidating at first, but you get used to it just like anything, and I love it.
I think it's every man's fantasy in life to drive a race car.
Wicketkeeper Reggie Chakabva's gritty unbeaten knock curtailed West Indies' victory bid as Zimbabwe managed a draw in the final session of the last day of the second test in Bulawayo today. The right-handed Chakabva remained unbeaten on a crucial 71 and was accompanied by captain Graham Cremer on 28. The pair added 91 for the 8 wicket to end the match on 301 for 7. Perched on 199 for 6 at lunch, Zimbabwe lost just one wicket in the second session, that of Sikander Raza, for 89. The right-hander, who also scored a half century in the first innings, added just 4 to his interval score before he was bowled by captain and seamer Jason Holder by one that nipped back off a length to claim off stump. His dismissal ended a 38-run stand for the 7th wicket with Shikabwa. That's Caribbean Intent. Join us again at 6:30 for Caribbean Newsline. Good afternoon.